even if you're doing just a quick rendering of a fossil, there's a couple things you're going to want to consider, namely the material on your fossil, the lighting, creating a scale bar so that you know the scale, and then the camera positioning. So to start, let's take a quick look at material properties. You can select the material properties for your object by selecting it by clicking on it, and then going down to this tab here in the properties window called material properties. You can create a new material just by clicking that new button. And then there's a lot of different options that come up, but for a quick render, I really just like to select the color and change it to something a little more bone-like, just like that. Okay, so now you'll see it has not previewed in our viewport yet, but we can switch the viewport setting to material preview, and now you'll see it's a little more bone colored. Now, of course, this is just an aesthetic choice. You could leave it gray if you wanted. Next, we'll want to consider what the lighting looks like. So in this view, we're just seeing light come from all sides, but if we want to see what it'll actually look like when we render, we have to click the render preview. And now you'll see everything looks very dark, and that's because our default light is a point light that spawns right at the origin, which is currently inside the mesh. So if I select this light, I can start to drag it up, and you'll see how it is affecting on the mesh as I move it around. Now, I have some fun playing around with lighting settings, creating new lights to try and get some nice lighting going on. However, one of the easiest things to do if you just want a quick render is to change your default light from point, which produces light kind of in a sphere, to sun, which will produce it from a direction. Now you can see it's very brightly lit up right now because sun defaults to a very strong strength. But if I turn this down to something like 10, maybe even a little lower, you'll see this actually defaults to a really nice lighting scheme for just a basic render of this object. And sun works by creating light rays in a direction from any source. So even if I move this around, you'll see the lighting stays the same. I can also change things like the color of the light if I really want to, but I'm just going to leave it on the white for the purposes of this. Okay, next up, I want to add a scale bar. So when I export this, I can correctly scale it in my images. And the way I do that is just by adding a plane, which I can do by going to add mesh plane, and then scaling it to 1 centimeter. So right now you can't see the plane, but it's selected. I can see in the scene collection here. So if I click these buttons, I can move it out. And I know that this scan was in units of millimeters, and that Blender works in units of meters, so I need this plane to be 10 quote-unquote meters long to reflect 1 centimeter of the scan. So if I go to the object properties here, you can actually see the scale right now is at 1 by 1 by 1. So if I just scale it along the y-axis to 10, now this represents 1 centimeter by my scan. And I don't worry about the material properties on this because I usually Photoshop over it anyway. It's more so just so I can get the correct scale. Okay, so final step before we render is to position the camera. And the easiest way to do this is to go to View, and then Frame Selected. I had to select my object first. Frame Selected. And now I can go to View and Align View and Align Active Camera to View. Now it looks like my object has disappeared, and that's because cameras have a default clipping plane while they'll stop rendering. But because this object is so big in the Blender scene, it's cut it off completely. So to fix that, I can select the camera up in the scene collection here. And I can go to the camera properties, and you'll see the clip ends at 1,000 meters according to Blender, but remember and convert that to millimeters in our head for the scan. So I'm just going to put it out to 1,000, and now we can see our calcanea. Now you'll notice, though, that it's being cut off, even though we could see it in the entire viewport, by what will be rendered by the camera, so we have to start moving our camera out. And the easiest way to do this is by pulling up the view properties, which is just a little arrow over there, going to view, and then checking camera, lock camera to view. Click away from that, and I'll get rid of this window just by dragging it back in. Okay, so now if I start scrolling, the camera will move with my movement, and I can position the camera however I think will be best for this image. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. Alright, final thing I want to do is I want the background to be transparent when I render this image. And that's just so when I'm importing this into Photoshop, it'll be a little easier to work with. So first thing you'll have to do is make sure it's saving in a format that is going to be compatible with transparent. For example, PNG is what I use. So if you go to the output properties with the camera selected, you can see file for and then select this PNG. I would also at least make sure you have RGBA selected, the A standing for alpha, which is what controls transparency. You'll see it has an output folder selected, but I'll be able to choose save as, so this isn't anything you really need to worry about. Okay, the second thing you'll need to do is go to these render properties here. You'll see a lot of different properties, not going to worry about them right now though, except for film, which will let us select this transparent background. And you'll see the grid appeared behind here that indicates that it's going to render as transparent. Okay, so I've got everything set up now. All I have to do is go to render, render image. And you can see my image has rendered here. I've got my nice scale bar here. You can see the whole calcanea. And it's got a transparent background, so I will be able to import it into Photoshop or a similar program to combine it with other images and make annotations on it, that sort of thing. So now, final step, I can just go to Save As and then navigate to wherever I would like to save it. A final thing to be aware of if you're rendering is there are two different renderers you should be using. Technically, Blender has three, which you can see under render properties here. I just used Eevee, which is kind of the quick working one, and it should work for most things, especially with these kind of simpler meshes. However, if you're not getting good results with Eevee, if there's something funky going on, Cycles is the ray tracing renderer, which means it's doing everything with light rays and it shouldn't have any kind of weird clipping or shadow issues that Eevee might develop. So if you're having trouble with Eevee, move to Cycles. Just know that it takes a lot more computer power to do.